Hello everyone. Here's a video that I never thought I would make. I think what I'm gonna do is just go back a little bit, give you a little bit of history before we get into what's happening right now, which is bad. Last year or so, these are things we've never shared with you guys. Never planned on sharing it, but it's gotten bad enough that I gotta say something. So everybody knows that Jaylene and I's situation, right? That's all public knowledge. And everybody knows how we're dealing with that. There's been a lot of crazy comments. Everybody's kind of seen that. That's all pretty apparent. But one of the things I want to talk about is last year, a YouTube subscriber called CPS on us and said that Ember wasn't even Jaylena and I's child, that it was, we just had this kid on our channel that we were using to get views and scam our viewers out of money. Now, obviously it sounds crazy. You hear that and it sounds crazy, right? Problem is, when somebody reports something like that, CPS has to come out and investigate. So we had to deal with that last year and just chalked it up to one of those weird, crazy things, right? Which is insane, right? Who would go out of their way to try and destroy our family like that? Obviously, Ember is our child. CPS just had to do an investigation and had to do their due diligence, right? It's all good, but the moral of the story is somebody is going out of their way to make our lives very difficult. I don't know how deep I'm going to get into all of this, but like, Jaylena and I aren't even very big YouTubers, really. Not really. Not when we're looking at like the grand scheme of YouTubers, we're small channels. So I can only imagine what some of these bigger channels deal with. I can 100% see why people would stop being YouTubers. Even before I was a YouTuber, I dealt with online bullying and hate. Anytime there's any type of success, quote unquote, there's people that can't stand you for having it. When my Instagram was doing well years ago, somebody deleted it. As the bus channel was doing well, there was people making videos about how I didn't know what I was talking. Like, it's just crazy. Anytime there's any type of quote-unquote success, there's as many people who love you for it, there's probably double the amount of people that don't like you for it, which is insane, okay? I'm not going to get into the nitty-gritty details on all of that because that's not what's happening right now. Now, we left the shop. We left the bus building business. And we bought Wild Mountain, right? It's a little 900 square foot double wide mobile home with a gigantic shop. Half of it turned into a recording studio. And there was two really cool tiny home structures here that Jaylena and I were really excited about building. Just in general and for the channel. I mean, I don't know if you can tell, but it's raining again. So nothing's happening right now. And we've kind of tinkered on them a little bit. And there's that weird addition to the back of the house that I've been trying to deal with when it wasn't raining. Jaylene has kind of touched on the tiny home barn at the top of the hill. And I recently just got back on it. But we also had the one down here that we intended on building into like a little tiny house for Airbnb. Basically, I'm going to get in. The whole reason we bought this property is for those two potential tiny home builds and the shop. That's it. We didn't buy this property because of the house. We bought the property because of those opportunities. Now, I want to say this. When you see a YouTube channel or anybody, an Instagram, a TikTok or whatever, and you see like hypothetically 80,000 subscribers, 50,000, whatever the number is, right? I was always under the assumption that those people were on your team, right? though you had, if you had 80,000 subscribers, you had 80,000 people that loved you, 80,000 people supporting you, 80,000 people watching and cheering you on. Like, that's what you would think, right? I have recently come to learn that's just 80,000 people paying attention. They don't necessarily like you. You can see that in our comment sections. Now, I also want to throw this out there. We are very, very, very blessed for the supporters that we have. I'm not going to say subscribers, because subscribers aren't necessarily a good thing. We're very blessed for the supporters that we do have that show up every week. They're commenting on the videos. They're just genuine, awesome, cool people. And like, you're the reason that we get to do YouTube for a living. I want to just start by saying that right there. Very blessed and thankful for the supporters of both Jaylene and I's channels. Because without you, we couldn't do this. And I know that, and I'm grateful, because what happens is we get to spend time with our daughter 24/7, right? I don't have to get up in the morning and leave and go to a building and work, and I'm gone all day and then come home and see my child for an hour a day, right? Jaylene and I, we both get to spend every single day with our beautiful baby girl. So we are blessed. I don't want to understate that. But there is a YouTube subscriber that called CPS on us trying to get our child taken away. That was a YouTube subscriber. Somebody you think is on our team. And they're not. They're... Yeah. Right? I just don't understand. So let's bring it back to right now. So we've been at this property. Let's talk about what's happening right now, which is why we're making this video now. It's tough. Anybody who's ever had a kid, it's hard. You know, like, it's great. It's beautiful. It's awesome. It's magical, but it's hard, right? And then we're trying to make money like everybody else and pay the bills like everybody else in this world. But then when you got these haters coming at you, doing everything in their power to, like, take you down, I don't think they realize they're affecting our family and our child, right? Like, when you're messing with somebody like that, you're affecting us being able to take care of our child. I don't understand why you got to mess with people. If I don't like you, I don't watch you, I don't care about you, I don't even know you exist, right? You don't need to mess with people. That's the problem in this world with the internet, is people aren't held accountable for their actions, right? So let's say somebody's standing here right now talking crap to me. I'm right here. I can do something about it, right? Real easy to get behind a keyboard and say something or do something and act tough when there's no consequences. Anyways, so we've been at Wild Mountain for about 6 months, and we've been doing what we can, right? I've been working on the property when I can. Jaylene has got a van build going on. We're doing what we can when we can. I started working on that back addition thing. And Jaylene kind of started the tiny home up there. But anyways, I get a letter the other day. And basically, I have been served by Lane County. And I'm like, what? And it's basically saying that I have illegal structures on the property. And I'm like, what? Like, we bought this place legit. So it's got to go through a title company, which is supposed to check everything, make sure that permits have been pulled for every structure. It's not, you know, you get what I'm saying? Like, I bought this place legally through a loan. Everything was checked and everything passed. So I'm like, what is going on? Which brings me to what happened. So we had a phone call, I don't remember, last week sometime. And guess what? A YouTube subscriber decided to email Lane County building codes and whatever and sent over my property tour that I did when we first bought this place, saying that we had illegal structures on the property. Right? So guess what happens? Now, Lane County has a report and they have to investigate. Now, they didn't know that the structures were illegal. I didn't know the structures that were illegal. And they just guessed and were trying to make our life very difficult. And I guess they guessed right. Lane County looks into whatever they got to look into. And they find out that there's three structures here that were never permitted, right? I got to be careful how much stuff I disclose here. I'm just going to keep it more broad strokes because it is a legal thing I'm dealing with at the moment. The whole back of the house, that whole addition was never permitted. But that's a thing. Both tiny homes that we bought the place for were not permitted. So, with that phone call, I was told that I have to tear them down or pay for a permit to make them legal. Which means they have to be up to code. I don't know how it all works. I'm in unfamiliar territory, right? I'm in uncharted waters. But hypothetically, we have to tear all three of those structures down. That's all my time this summer, which means I will be able to do nothing else. It's gonna cost money, which if you've been watching past videos, I've been getting ready to start another business so I could create money. So now, instead of making money, I'm going to spend money and go broke without making any money. All because of a YouTube subscriber. Okay, let's talk about that again. I'm very grateful for our supporters. Let me just make it very clear. So there's no gray area and you know where I stand. If you're on this channel, if you watch this channel and you have such a problem with me and Jaylena that you're, because this is just stuff I know about. Who knows what people are doing that I don't know about. And you're making these types of phone calls or you're doing these types of things to try and hurt our family, I do not want you here. I want you to unsubscribe and leave. We don't want you here. Right? At all. Leave. Unsubscribe. Go make somebody else's life difficult. We don't want you here. If I see any funky comment come through on my channel, I'm going to assume you are one of these funky people and I will just block you. There will be no, I used to be nice about it, but at this point, like, If there's anything even remotely funky in the comment section, I'm just going to block you because I'm going to assume you're one of these types of people. Now, I know that not obviously everyone here isn't one of these types of people. So the people that are here for those types of reasons, I want you gone. And when I find you, I'll make you gone. We love making YouTube videos. We love our supporters. We love doing this, right? And we're going to continue doing this. So for all of our supporters out there that are here just supporting us and cheering us on and helping us with your comments or showing up to the live chats, thank you. We love you guys, literally. Like, you make our life possible, and we're so grateful. I never thought I'd have to make this type of video, but if you're here just to try and watch us burn, I need you to leave. I have an almost 2-year-old daughter that I am trying to provide a life for. I don't care if you don't like me, right? But I have a child that is innocent, has nothing to do with anything. Please just leave our family alone and let us provide for our child. I feel like I shouldn't even have to make this video. So I guess for our supporters on our channels, if you spot any of these types of people on our channel, let us know. and I'll X them out immediately. So I'm putting all of you people that are doing this to our family on notice. There's no passes. When I find you, you are gone immediately. We cannot afford to have you here. And for our supporters, again, I'm so grateful, so thankful for you guys. I'm not trying to make this a negative video, but I'm trying to be blatantly clear where I'm at and where I stand. And I am just so disappointed with people. People can be so terrible. Like, you're gonna email CPS, you're gonna email the county and try and ruin our lives? For what end? Like, that's taking time out of somebody's day. Like, I don't understand why you can't just go do something else. Go get eat a Twinkie or something. Why you gotta be here causing chaos? So yeah, so basically that's probably the end of both tiny homes. The whole reason we bought this place is now gone, and the rest of my year is gonna be dealing with it. Yeah, not a great update, right? I honestly can't even believe what's happening. And I can't wrap my head around that it's a YouTube subscriber that's doing it. And probably more than one. It's not, you know what I'm saying? Why would you subscribe to somebody if you don't like them that much? I don't get it. We've been talking for a while. I'm going to wrap this up. I'm in uncharted territory here. I got served legal documents. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm trying to figure it out. And I'm wondering what's next. What's the next thing that's going to happen that somebody's going to do? Like, it never lets up. JD's flying up. Actually, he's going to be here tomorrow. And I have to go have a meeting with the county and basically find out what my options are. So JD's gonna fly up and then help me figure this out. And if I do have to demo each one of those structures, it's gonna take a dumpster, which is $1,000 a piece. Best case scenario, I just have to pay for permits for all this stuff. I don't know what that's gonna cost. You would think I bought the place like this, I'd be grandfathered in, which is the first thing that I said, and I was wrong. Doesn't matter. I'm the property owner, therefore it's my responsibility. Yeah. So, that's a huge hang up, and that's pretty much what this channel is gonna turn into, is me taking care of this problem. Whether I have to tear all the tiny homes down or what, I don't know. So we're both gonna find out together how this is gonna go. I just wanted to hop in here and put it out on the table on what is going on and what we're dealing with and ask for your help. If you're not a supporter, I'm asking you to leave. And if you are a supporter, if you spot any of these types of people on the channels, please let us know immediately and I will get rid of them. So hopefully we can have a nice, happy, peaceful community here once again, doing whatever we're doing once we get rid of the riffraff. So it's time to clean house. Love and respect, y'all. It's a pretty brutal video. But I feel like I just need to put everybody on the same page. That's what we're dealing with right now. And the stuff that we've dealt with that we haven't talked about. So, all right, I'm going to end this. And again, thank you guys so much. If you're a supporter of the channel, so much love and appreciation. And hopefully it ain't too bad. I'll find out this week. So, I'll see you guys in another video.